Hi, my name is Tanka Dahal and I am software engineer at Microsoft for over 15 years and I have taken several interviews and hiring decisions. In today's video, I'll take a very simple question and then go through what an interviewer looks for and then how you should answer those questions. And then I'll also show you 4 to 5 different solutions to this question and then I'll explain why one is better than other. Let's go through it. Question asked to you by interviewer is write a program to reverse number in a given area. Few tips that I want to provide you is do not start the solution right away. Ask relevant questions. These questions are just samples. You will have to prepare your own question. So some of the questions that you should ask for this particular is, okay, you said numbers in a given array. What type of numbers are they? Integers? Are they float, double, or anything else? Can that array be empty? Or can there be duplicate? Or can there be negative numbers? Can there be any very large numbers? Or you can say, okay, I can reverse a given array with an inbuilt function, but can I use inbuilt function? Or can I use an array or other storage equal to the length of the given array? Or can I use extra storage or anything else, right? Think about the test cases or error cases. And then when you are writing code, catch all the test cases, catch all the error cases. If you just write the code and then at the end, oh, I forgot this error case. Oh, I forgot that exception case. Then that will not give you any benefit. So think all those ahead of time. When you are thinking of any approach, think loud, meaning when you are thinking, speak up, explain your approach or algorithm to the interviewer. And if you have more than one approach of solving any problem, ask your interviewer which one of them he or she likes, and then also ask which one does he want you to implement. And then he says, okay, go ahead, implement any of them. Then you should make a wise decision that you should choose one of them which is better in performance. Let's go to two solutions now. Before going there, I have a Visual Studio here. I'll use Visual Studio because it helps debugging, and then I'm writing code in C sharp. But feel free to use any online IDEs. For example, if you see here, I'm using .NET Fiddle. Write your code and then just run it, and then you will see the results right here. Feel free to do anything, but I'll use Visual Studio here. And don't worry about all these namespace classes and then static void, whatever these things. So for now, I have an array. I have 4 or 5 different solutions, and then all of them gives the same result. All of those 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all of them giving same reverse order of the same code. Now let's go through that. I have that array. I am iterating through that array in reverse order. If you see that, I am starting from array length -1 and then until the value of the index I is greater than equals to 0, go through in reverse order and then print that, right? And if I just copy this part and then put it here, for example, the same code is here, this gives exactly same result. In second phase, the interviewer might ask, okay, can you write this code in a function? And what you should do is, rather than just displaying here, let's see, you converted that program into a function and then you call that function and then say, okay, now reverse. Now you just copied code from there and then put it into a function and then you call the function and then this gives exactly same result, right? This is one of the app, but this is not the best app. Let's go to second. Second is reverse to, and then for simplicity, what I have done is I have copied this code into a function and then I have just called the function. If you go down and then see what reverse to looks like, this code is exactly from first approach. I am just passing that array as argument and then print that. That's it. Meaning first approach and second approach is exactly same, but you copied this code into a function and call it. Now let's go to three. If you notice in the reverse to, what I am doing is the return type is void, meaning I am not returning anything. I am just printing it here, right here. But the interviewer might ask you is, okay, rather than printing here, can you return the array? In that case, let's go to reverse three. What you do is you pass array. Now I have a temporary array of the same length and you say, okay, iterate through the array from the opposite order, meaning take the last number first and then display them here. Let me quickly show. In this case, what I am doing is I am taking this number first and then print 9 and then go back and then print 7. So I am printing this in reverse order basically. If you go and see the code, I am doing nothing, but I am taking the last number first, print it, and then go to second last and third last and then print it here. So I am saving all those into a temporary array and then return that array. That's it. So this is better than the second approach because it is returning the value to the caller so that he can still manipulate the value. But still we are using equal or same length array here to store all these numbers. This is the original array. This is the array that we created. So equal or same length array. This is definitely not the best solution. Now let's go to number four. Number four is in place edit. In place edit meaning, if you see number three, we are using a new array of the same length. But here, if you see, I am not using a new array at all. What I am doing is I am just manipulating the values from the same array. Okay, let me explain what is happening here. In this case, our value of s is 0 at the moment. Right here, e is array length minus 1, meaning e is pointing at the end. S is start, e is end, pointing at the end. Area length is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 minus 1 is 4. So value of e is 4 here. And then what we say is, okay, when e is greater than equals to s, meaning whenever this e is greater than or equals to s, then loop. So what we do is we have a TMP. We have one temporary storage, which is array int. Array int meaning this guy. We are storing 9 in TMP. And then we say, okay, array e is array s. Now instead of this array e, we replace that with array start. Now 1 comes here, right? 9 is gone, 1 comes here. And then array start is TMP. Now array start is replaced by the TMP. TMP is 9. So 1 and 9 are swapped. Basically, start plus plus, start is 1, end minus minus, end is now 3. And then now go and say, end still greater than equals to s. Yeah, end is still greater than equals to s. So do the same thing. TMP is array e. So now value of TMP is array e. What is e? E is 3. Array 3 is 7. So TMP is 7. Now array e is array s. Now array e is array s. S is 1. Array 1 is 3. So 3 comes here. Array s is TMP. S meaning 1. So this goes and then it is replaced by TMP, which is 7. So if you see, 7 and 3 are replaced. And then in third one, 5. Finally, in 3 steps, this whole array is reversed. So what we do here is we haven't used the same exact same length array. This is in place edit. We are manipulating the exactly same array and then we did it. So this approach is definitely better than 1, 2 or 3 because we don't use extra storage. And then now the question might come, okay, what I have to go through all these long codes when I already have inbuilt function. Generally ask interviewer, but we don't know how is this reverse array dot reverse implemented internally. That might have more performance issues than the code that you have written. This is transparent. Everybody knows what you are doing, but here you don't know what it is doing. So they don't want you to use inbuilt functions in interview at least. So although this looks elegant, also this looks performant, sweet, easy, don't go with it. So my recommendation is go with approach number 4. And then do it. I hope this gave you some idea on how do you solve the problem in interview. See you in next video.